Here I have some parts made of plastic. This is a prototype. It's made of plastic and it's injection molded. And if you want one of these, you will need $5,000. This is an Old Spice hair gel cap. If you want this cap, you're gonna need $8. $6 for this cap. You'll need some Wilson tennis balls. $3 for this cap. That's a Folgers coffee. If you want this product, it's gonna be $1.50 and it's made of PVC plastic. And if you want this cap, it's gonna be 30 cents. And this is a mason jar lid. So which one do you think is the best engineered? Which one do you think has the most refined manufacturing process and the tightest tolerances? I'll give you a clue. It's not that one. That one's the most early in development with the fewest engineering hours. It's also not these, because the companies that made these are selling a product, not a cap. And it is these. These ones have been refined for many, many years. They have a lot of competition and multiple manufacturers are making them. And these are not only the lowest cost, but the best engineered products. What we're looking at is prototype, product, and commodity. And yes, these products themselves are commodities, but the lids are not. The lids are an item that comes with a commodity product. So if you were going to engineer a system, what are you going to use for your caps? Think about it. If you look at 3D printing in the world of manufacturing, here's a 3D printed cap that's designed to fit this PVC tube, CPVC, and the cap is only like 10 or 20 cents worth of plastic, and it does not have the strength and the density and the waterproofness that you can get from the commodity. It underperforms with respect to the commodity, and it also costs more. It's not actually gonna be 20 cents. If you want one of these tomorrow, you're gonna have to have it ordered from a 3D printing company. Call that $6. So you have $6 versus $1.50, and you can't compete. So we're not gonna compete.